Hi, my name is Ashley Puff. I just won the girls' Eastern States race after I had an invite, and you're watching Winter States Time.
Oh yeah, 13:58 for Aisling, just 3 seconds off the course record at the Manhattan Invite. And that was just one of the many splendid things I witnessed this weekend. I was also in Boston for the USA Women's 10K Road Racing Championships, where I joined Kevin Ullman, who's been at all those USA running circuit races up to this point, and there's just one more to go. But I just got back from Boston, so I'm gonna keep it short this week. I'm gonna focus more on the races that I was at. And without further ado, let's let the news do the talking, which actually is going to be me reading the news to you. So let's let me continue to do the talking.
Runner Space Rundown.
The Runner Space Network site of the week is NikeCrossNationals.com. You've probably seen it before, but check out the sweet new revamp. You can check out all the different regions by clicking around on the left side, and we have video from the past 6 years. I mean, really, the site is incredible, I promise. It's the High School Rundown. At the Manhattan Invite, our show introducer and the nation's top-ranked female, Ashlyn Cuff of Cornwall, New York, won the girls' Eastern States race in a 13:58, becoming the third girl to ever run faster than 14 minutes on the 2.5 mile course. And she also took 5 seconds off her winning time from last year. And the U.S. top-ranked girls team, Fayetteville Manly, has won for the fourth year in a row. They were led by the overall second-place finisher, Jillian Fanning, who ran a 14:16. And Tattnall High School took second place, led by Haley Pierce, who was third with a 14:22. And the Boys Eastern States Championship was won by last year's runner-up, West Windsor Plainsboro's Jim Rosa, in a 12:28. He was followed by Edward Chesrek of St. Benedict's in a 12:34. And the most winningest guys team was Shaker High School with 102 points, followed by Christian Brothers Academy with 144. Check out hundreds of photos and video from every race. And some news from meets that I wasn't at. At the Nike South Invitational in Texas, Craig Lutz got his third straight win here in a 14:56. And Rachel Johnson won the girls' race by 30 seconds in a 17:27. Also, the pre-OFSA Invitational in Ontario, Canada was this weekend. Xavier King of Pickering High School in Ajax, Ontario won the boys' 7K senior race in a 22:18. And the senior girls' 5K was won by Elizabeth Whelan from Branksome Hall High School in Toronto in an 18:58. Check out all things Ontario High School running at runnerspace.com/OFSAA. It's the College Pro Rundown. With NCAA D1 pre-nationals next week, this was more or less an idle week for college cross country. But the Commonwealth Games are going on in New Delhi, India. In the men's 800, Kenyan Boaz Along won all his prelim races and the final, taking home the gold in the 146.6. Uganda's Moses Kipsero got the 5K 10K sweep with a 13:31 and a 27:57. Also in the 5K, Northern Arizona's David McNeil, who is Australian, took 8th in a 13:47. In the men's 1500, Silas Kiplagat, who this summer ran the fastest 1500 over the past 4 years, won in a significantly slower 3 minutes 41 seconds. New Zealand's Nick Willis was third with a 3:42. Nancy Lungott of Kenya won the women's 1500 in a Commonwealth Games record 4:05.26, and she also won the 800 in a 2 flat. It's the Road Racing Rundown. On to that women's US 10K Championships, hosted by the Tufts Health Plan 10K in Boston, Massachusetts. This was the second to last race in this year's USA running circuit, with only the Women's Marathon Championships left on November 7th. The US 5,000 meter record holder Molly Huddle got her third straight title here. She ran a 32 flat and had a strong finish, holding off the overall second place finisher, Kenyan Genoveva Keegan. Keegan, of course, being Kenyan, was not a part of the US Championships. And Jen Rines finished third overall with a 32:16, taking the runner-up position for the championship. And the US running circuit leader, Katie McGregor, rounded out the U.S. top three with a 32:45. This was a great race. Check out the finish video, the live webcast replay, photos, and more at usarunningcircuit.com. Oh, and also running recreationally in that race was Joan Benoit Samuelson, the first ever women's Olympic marathon champion, which segues nicely into another little road race this weekend, the Chicago Marathon, where a day earlier, 53-year-old Samuelson ran a 2:47.50. But the overall winner in the women's race was Lilia Shubakova of Russia in a 2:20.25. And Sammy Wanjaro of Kenya defended his title on the men's side with a 2:06.24. It is time for a Runnerspace quick tip. If you didn't know, you can embed YouTube videos on Runnerspace. Here's what you do. Go to YouTube, find the video you want to put on Runnerspace, and copy the video code from the URL, which is up here. It's the 11-letter code after the equals sign. Fill out all the necessary forms on the Runnerspace video upload page. Paste the YouTube code in the box near the bottom, and select YouTube from the drop-down menu titled Service. Press continue, and you're done. If that particular YouTube video has already been uploaded to Runnerspace, you'll see this error message. Scroll down, click the link to the video, and from there, you can attach it to your profile, event, or group site.
Okay, well, that's the way the cookie crumbles. That about does it for this week. I'm really fresh off the plane, still snacking on the airline peanuts. Bulky, but I consider them a carry-on. Runner's Pace Live, signing out.